Hi, I'm Dr. Jamuna Pai and welcome to Beauty Secrets. I've been in the business for over 25 years and now I want to share with you all the tips and tricks I have learned along the way. Follow me to get an insider view on how to get great skin for life. Today, I'm going to address the most common queries I get from my male clients. Today, men are coming to my clinic expressing interest in procedures like facials and even cosmetic enhancements. I love answering all their questions, and I thought I would share the most common queries that I get asked by men in the hope that it will help all of you watching there. When people come with acne, 100% improvement. When they come with pigmentation, we can give a whole lot of treatment to them and a cure. But when it comes to hair fall and hair loss, we have to first treat the cause, and then there could be supplements like we're taking amino acids or protein supplements, biotin, saw palmetto. Some doctors prescribe minoxidil. Now minoxidil improves the circulation around the hair root, improves the hair shaft, but it has to be used permanently for continuous sustained results. Actually, if nothing works where hair loss is concerned and where it is hereditary, one of the quickest, easiest, hygienic ways is to shave the hair off and learn to carry yourself well. I think that is a great option. The other one, which is non-surgical, non-invasive, is hair weaving. And so a piece of hair is woven in, but that requires regular touch-ups. And the last, for everlasting results, get a hair transplant done. I would keep it as short as possible for men in their skincare routines. So I would ask them only to cleanse, that's very important, to protect their skin and hydrate. Now in the cleanse, I would prefer them to use high concentration face washes rather than use soap bars, because that sometimes can change the pH levels, making the skin dry, making the skin a little taut, and dryness can make it very uncomfortable and strip the natural oils away. When you're talking about protecting the skin, men should use a sunscreen of at least SPF 50 or above, because we tell women to repeat the use of their sunscreen at least twice or more in a day. But for men, I don't think they would repeat it again. So at least a very thick coat of an SPF 50 or more will go a long way in protecting their skin. Last but not the least, using a moisturizer, just like women do, as soon as they shower, just use a moisturizer on the wet skin. As thick as possible, it will absorb it well, and on the face, use a sunscreen on top of the moisturizer. When I started my clinics 25 years ago, I used to see only women. Over a period of time, the women started getting in their husbands, their sons for acne, and also the awareness amongst men increased so much that today we have men coming for all kinds of treatments, from acne to Botox to dermal fillers and laser hair reduction. Well, men's skin is thicker than that of women. It has more oily glands. Presence of hair in areas like the chin, the sideburns, the upper lip and the chest. But essentially it remains the same and has to be looked after just like women do. Skin is skin, whether it is men or women. Only thing that we are looking at is the concentration of the active ingredients that are present in these products, which could be a little higher because of the thickness, because of the excess oil in the skin. It needs to penetrate that much more. But otherwise, you have to choose what kind of a skin you have, oily, dry, combination, and choose your products accordingly. Well, the post-workout regime is extremely important because your skin is all flushed, the pores are all open, your skin is sweating, excreting the impurities. So cleanse the face well. The sweat shouldn't just dry on the skin. Have a shower, use cool water, don't use cold water. Just like I said, the pores are all open, we want it to do its job. Don't shut it with cold water. Hydrate yourself by drinking lots and lots of water. Well, I do understand the flip side of socializing. Just 2 drinks a week will not necessarily accelerate aging. But over a period of time, this becomes a regular habit, and that can aid the aging process. Remember, alcohol converts straight into sugar, which makes the system acidic. And sugar is the biggest culprit to cause aging. Alcohol causes dehydration, which in causes leads to drying of the skin, and this leads to early wrinkling and eventually aging. Well, I wish there was an antidote for alcohol consumption, but in any case, what we want to do is dilute the effects of alcohol on our body and skin. So drink lots of water. You can add a little lime because your goal is to make your system as alkaline as possible, and lime helps with just that. Avoid caffeine as it could further lead to dehydration of the skin. You should also aid the body by supplying sufficient intake of antioxidants in the form of fruits, vegetables, oral supplements. These antioxidants are nothing but a group of vitamin A, C, E, along with minerals such as selenium, magnesium, manganese, etc. These are found in abundance in dark and deep colored vegetables and fruits such as beetroot, spinach, broccoli, etc. One should look after your skin no matter how old you are. It will definitely affect the way that your skin ages. So using an very expensive product or not an expensive product is really not the bottom line. What is important is that you're choosing the right ingredients in your products as per your skin type, as per your age, and that will go a long way in helping you to delay the aging process. Thank you for watching Beauty Secrets with Dr. Jamuna Pai, and I hope this has been helpful to you. For more videos like these, don't forget to subscribe.